With more and more of our time being spent interacting with digital devices like smartphones and computers, our hands are more important than ever. At Carnegie Mellon University, and in partnership with Meta, we are working to make human-computer interaction available to everyone, including the over 1 million people living with paralysis from spinal cord injury. Hand control is made possible by a network of neurons that link the brain to the muscles of the arm. The spinal cord is a vital part of this network, and when an injury to the spinal cord occurs, communication between the brain and muscles is interrupted, resulting in weakness or even complete paralysis. However, we discovered a few years ago that the muscles of the arm can still receive some signals from the brain, even in people that are unable to move their fingers. Those signals are too weak to generate force in the muscles, but are clear enough to allow us to detect the person's intended action, such as flexing a finger to type on a keyboard. My team in the neuromechatronics lab at Carnegie Mellon University is collaborating with Meta to implement their surface electromyography wristband research prototype for performing computer-based tasks like typing and gaming. Our goal is to empower people with spinal cord injury to interact with digital devices. Whether it be for work or play, we believe everyone should have access to technologies that have become such an integral part of our personal and professional lives. We are building upon both our own prior research and Meta's scientific work to detect and use motor units for control. We are excited by our early results. Our first participant, Nathan Copeland, has been unable to move his fingers since suffering a spinal cord injury in 2005. With this wearable device, Nathan was able to control a computer cursor and gamepad buttons on his very first day of testing, demonstrating just how intuitive it is to use this technology, which is as simple as putting on a wristwatch or a bracelet. The key to our approach is that it doesn't rely on physical motion, which is normally required to move a mouse or type on a keyboard. The wearable device uses sensors placed on the skin to measure the electrical signals that are generated by muscles when the user attempts to move. In this case, it enables Nathan to play video games and even exercise his creativity. Nathan's an artist and enjoys drawing, so we're working to integrate the SEMG controller with a custom painting app that we're developing for the MetaQuest Pro headset, enabling him to bring new paintings to life using a combination of eye movement and SEMG control. We're looking forward to seeing what new portraits Nathan and others will create with this technology. Our ultimate goal for this project is to develop technology that eliminates barriers to participation for people that have lost the use of their hands due to spinal cord injury. While easy to take for granted, we rely heavily on our hands to perform all activities of daily life. Whether it's things we do for work, like typing email, or things we do for fun, like playing video games or engaging in social media, we rely on our hands to connect with the world around us. We and our collaborators at Meta are committed to developing technology that is inclusive, and we are excited about enabling people with spinal cord injury to reconnect with colleagues, friends, and family.